Hi and welcome to Score Game. In this video we're going to play one of the best decks that you can play right now if you want to climb, Thresh Nasus. I played all versions of all decks that people are playing right now, and I honestly think for me at least, this is the best deck in the meta. It's really good versus all Azir Irelia decks, it's good versus Discard Aggro, it's good versus Draven Ezreal, and it has a good chance of winning against most decks. This deck has a really good early game and your opponents are going to struggle to survive, and if they do survive, you just finish the game with Nasus and Atrocity. You have the decode in the description and you can also find a link that will help you get the code if you play on mobile. Let's play some games. Hey, we're playing against Draven Jinx. I really hate this deck. This card aggro shouldn't exist. I hate it because this Draven Jinx deck can beat literally every other deck and can also lose to every other deck. It's just based on luck, it's so stupid. I'm not gonna play the Dawnkeeper versus Draven Jinx, I'm just gonna use it to block some units. Okay, here I'm just gonna Fading Icon. And we're gonna trade like this. I think we're gonna win with this hand. Looks pretty good. And Thresh. Okay, I'm gonna go with the Bakai. And I think that's all I'm gonna do. Hopefully he doesn't have Draven here. Okay. I guess I should have attacked. Okay. Just gonna take your Poro and your Battlecaster with me. Now I have board control. He has only 3 cards. Pretty good. And soon I'm gonna be able to play Thresh as well. Time for the main event. Sadly, he got Draven. I'm gonna Spirit Leech here. Kill this. Glimpse and another Vile Fist. I like it. Hopefully he's gonna attack with the Spider and Draven. Now we're cooking. Yeah, I think he's gonna attack with all of them. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna do that block. Okay, Nasus is pretty big. And surrender. Okay, we have a classic matchup here, Draven Ezreal versus Nasus Thresh. And we're gonna keep Dawnkeeper Glimpse Beyond, should we? Maybe even Black Spear to deal with an Ezreal or a Draven. I'm gonna keep Glimpse and Dawnkeeper. The desert by my side. Azir's command. This matchup is really hard. And he kind of has the advantage. Hopefully I'm gonna get the Ravenous Butcher. I guess not. Why is darkness to the unseen? The card that I'm most afraid of is Mystic Shot. As long as he has a mana to cast Mystic Shot, I can't really Glimpse Beyond. But I think if I play around Mystic Shot, I'm gonna lose anyway. I'm just gonna attack with the Curse Keeper, I'm not gonna Glimpse Beyond. He has Mystic Shot for sure. Okay, Atrocity, that's good. Ezreal, that's bad. I guess my Baka is gonna get double Mystic Shotted, most likely. Can't stop me. I guess we're gonna go for it, but he has another Mystic Shot for sure, maybe I shouldn't. I'm not gonna go for it. I'm pretty sure he has another one. Okay, we can deal with Ezreal if he doesn't die to this trash because of Culling Strike. Mystic Shot into Ravenous Flock. I told you he has another one. I'm gonna do it like this because trash is dead, and this way at least he can block one of my units with a Sentry. And we can also use Glimpse here because it can be stopped with 2 mana. I mean, it can be stopped by Ravenous Flock, but I think if you had Ravenous Flock, you wouldn't go for Scorched. So this is pretty good. We managed to deal 10 damage. He has 5 health left and we have Atrocity. Nasus isn't that big though. Another Glimpse. I'm gonna go for this because I don't think he has another Mystic Shot, and now we're gonna Black Spear this Ezreal. The reason why I didn't wait for him to use the Mystic Shot before I Glimpse Beyond it is because he could just not use it at all. Okay, this is fine. Oh, I think you're gonna need that Guile though. Oh, another Curse Keeper, that's really good. This is huge. Curse Keeper into Caretaker is huge. And I have mana to Vile Feast or Glimpse Beyond. He has another blocker, sadly. This is really good. We're gonna slay a lot of units, and he's also running out of cards. We have Nasus, we have a Trusty, and he has 4 health left, and we have a Rite of Negation as well. Really good. I can Glimpse Beyond, but I don't really need to. I think I value my mana right now a lot more. I'm just gonna Nasus. It's gonna be really hard for him to kill my Nasus. I mean, I want to deny it just because it's gonna summon a 7 cost follower. Don't really need to deny it though. I think it's fine. He can have his follower. An elusive. I'm gonna need this Rite of Negation to protect Nasus, so it's fine. Pretty disgusting that he got an elusive. I don't know if this is the correct play. I think I should have just attacked. That was the correct play. Yeah, I should have just attacked, but it's fine. Life and death inexorably interwoven. Rasmus has spell shield now. There's no way he's gonna stop this atrocity. That I don't even need to use because I'm just gonna attack. Everything's easier behind a mask. I kind of want to try and end it without atrocity, if possible. Even though if I adjust atrocity, I don't think there's anything he can do. Oh god. He actually had two tri beams in his starting hand and he lost. GG. We grow wiser with each victory. We were playing against Renekton Sejuani and he also has a Sivir. I'm gonna keep Glimpse Beyond as well, why not? This end is interesting. The Emperor commands, the land obeys. Always forward. Come on, bro. I'm gonna go with Fading Icon. The Winter's Claw strikes. Okay. There's a high chance he's gonna grab this Fading Icon with an exhaust. Or maybe not. Yep, as I said. Leave nothing standing. Azir's command. We're gonna do it like this. Ooh, that's an amazing card. Amazing draw. Two amazing draws. Okay. Hopefully he doesn't have Troll Chant. Or Renekton. Well, at least we know he can't use Troll Chant. He has only one mana left. Okay, this is really good. Actually, I should have used the Rite of Negation on the Caretaker as well before I attack. Wait, what is this guy doing? Never mind, I guess it didn't matter that I didn't write off calling before I attacked. Interesting decision. I'm pretty sure that means he has another Renekton. And if he has another Renekton and exhaust, I can't play Thresh. Okay, Ruin Runner. Okay, so far so good. I guess I should have played the Fakai as well. Ooh. Okay, I'm just gonna go with Nasus. I mean, if he decides not to block, and I don't think he's gonna block, we can just end it with a Trusty next turn. He's blocking. Interesting. I could have just Glimpse Beyond the Hunter so we can level up Nasus, but I don't know what to say about that. That's nice. I think this game is over. Yep. We grow wiser with each victory. And we're finally playing against an Azira Aurelia deck. I'm gonna keep the Curse Keeper and that's about it. Come on, Revenant's Butcher. No Revenant's Butcher. Still no Revenant's Butcher. Pretty unlucky. But we have Thresh. Thresh is really good in this matchup. He's not doing anything. Or he's just waiting for me to do something, but I don't think that's the case. I'm just gonna end the round, why not?
You need not follow, but you will witness.
Oops, I should have attacked. Come on. I should have totally attacked there. I missed one damage, oh no. Doesn't really matter in this matchup that much, but I think we're gonna easily win this one. His start was insanely weak. Do we Black Spear that? Oh wait, we have Vile Fist. What am I even saying? He has another one. Okay. I was afraid of another one, but it's fine.
Destiny calls.
He's attacking with Azir as well. Hmm. Okay, he only managed to deal 6 damage, and now we play Thresh and win the game. Oh my god, that's bad. Maybe I should just grab this inspiring marshal so we can kill it with black spear next turn. Okay, we only need to survive this turn and we win the game. But it's going to be really hard to survive this turn and keep Thresh alive. Oh my dear god. I think I have fading icon. You must know me, little one. You must. He has two more attacks. I guess I should have played on keeper instead of the fading icon. Oh my god, he's passing? No way. He doesn't want to level up Thresh. That's why he's passing.
Gonna find a gift for Renekton, right, Arda?
Thresh needs 4 more units. I don't think we can level him up. Okay. Okay. I am honored. Is he gonna attack or why did he do that? Okay, let's think about it. He can do an attack with Blade Dancer. I don't think I can afford to play Nasus. I think I just need to attack. Can I play Nasus? If I play Nasus, Thresh is gonna die. Maybe I should just play the Dawnkeeper first so I can have some blockers. And then I can play Nasus. Does he have another one? I think it's too risky to play Nasus. Is it? I mean, if he has another Ribbon Dancer, I don't care, but if he has the Blossoming Blade guy, Thresh is gonna die. The But if he doesn't have the Blossoming Blade guy, I think we just win by playing Thanasus.
To the street! Show them the might of our army.
Okay, we need to kill this guy more than we need to kill Azir, I think. And this way Thresh also lives. Okay, so far so good. Atrocity. Let's go. Let's go! Sit down. You were playing against Draven Ezreal. Yeah, I'm only gonna keep these two. Hopefully I'm gonna get Ravenous Butcher. Rite of Negation is really good in this matchup, but I really need the Ravenous Butcher. Triple Curse Keeper and two Fading Icons. Wow. Interesting. I'm gonna go with the Fading Icon. I can deal 3 damage. Hopefully. I mean, if he's gonna Mystic Shot the Fading Icon, it's pretty worth for me.
Humanity is obsolete.
3 damage. Thermal Beam. Okay. I can't Glimpse Beyond while he has 3 mana because he can just cancel it with a Mystic Shot. Now we can. Okay, interesting. I wanted to use Spirit Leech, but I think I'm just gonna do another Curse Keeper. Oh wow. Okay, we're just gonna play the Curse Keeper and then I'm gonna think about it. If I play the Bakai's, they can't really attack. Because of the bots. If I had another Ravenous Butcher, it would have been GG. I'm gonna have to Fading Icon sadly, instead of the Bakai's.
Remember me, little one. Please.
I mean, he kind of has to trade the Ballistic Boots or he's gonna take insane amounts of damage. Yeah. And there goes a Mystic Shot as well. Okay, this is looking good. he has only 5 cards left, same as me, but I have some extra units on board. I don't want to see an Ezreal. Come on, you bastard. This is just gonna die. Damn. Kind of bullshit. Watch and learn. Can't stop me. Okay, I need Black Spear to deal with this stupid Ezreal. Ooh, that's huge. Another Curse Keeper into another Ravenous Watcher. We double Bakai on the field. He has 7 mana too. Okay, 4 mana. Okay, this is pretty good. And I also have mana to Vile Fist something. Okay. Okay, what's that? Another Mystic Shot? Oh wait, I completely messed up this Vile Fist. I should have Vile Fisted my Fading Icon. This way I would have slain one extra unit. I wouldn't have lost the Spiderling. And I would have made it harder for Ezreal to level up. Big misplay. Come on, Nasus. Atrocity. Okay. We can actually just Atrocity, the Abomination, and end the game. What can he actually do? Let me think. Okay, never mind, he can just Ravenous Flock. Freaking Ravenous Flock. Sure. If he's gonna Ravenous Flock the Abomination, I think I'm gonna trust him. I mean, what's the chance of him having two of them? I mean, it's pretty high, but I'm gonna go for it. He only has 3 cards. There we go. Sit down. Okay, we're playing against Shyvana Aurelion Soul. This Shyvana Aurelion Soul deck is really good right now because it counters my deck, it counters Draven Ezreal, and it also counters the Aurelia Azir deck. So this is gonna be a hard one. I'm gonna keep one Revenant's Watcher. Hopefully we're gonna get a Curse Keeper. Okay, this end is complete trash. If I don't get Curse Keeper, I think it's doomed. Come on, Curse Keeper. Yeah, it's doomed. I can't be allowed to have this bad of a start versus his deck.
Break their spirits and their souls.
Okay, not bad. Still really, really bad though. I have to do this, but it's so bad. I'm so far behind. I've lost games versus his deck, even with good starts. There's the Curse Keeper, a bit too late. I mean, we can still use him. And he also kind of had a bad hand. No Shyvana. Okay, now he has Shyvana. But it's fine, I think we can win this.
Dragon blood is the master's heart.
I'm just gonna trash here. And this isn't bad at all, I think. We can kind of level up Thresh next turn. And he's out of mana. I'm gonna block Shyvana with Spirit Leech.
Run them through. Hardly fair.
Okay. Maybe we can even level up Thresh before we attack. Ooh, I think we can. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we can. Oh, I think we just won. We just freaking won.
Everyone's a garden.
I can just Black Spear Shyvana, but in case he's gonna single combat, I think I want to use Black Spear after he single combats. Maybe I should just use it here. Okay, let's just make sure Thresh levels up first. And then I can just Black Spear Shyvana. We can grab the dragon with Thresh and attack with Nasus. But he just surrenders. Okay, this was actually insanely easy. As you can see, this deck can beat all the other decks in the meta, even with me making small mistakes. Probably the strongest deck against this deck is Aurelion Sol Shyvana, or Aurelion Sol Zoe, mainly because of Hash. Hash is such a strong card against Nasus, and also because Aurelion Sol decks have units with lifesteal, so they can survive early and mid game, and they can deny your Nasus Atrocity ending. This is going to be the end for this video, thanks a lot for watching. I try and post Runeterra videos with new decks as often as I can. Leave a like to this video if you enjoyed it, ask me anything you want in the comments, I reply to every single comment. Subscribe and hit the bell for more decks and more Runeterra content. And I'll see you in the next one. Peace.